Where along the way did we become lonely? Sometimes, even when we're not alone, we find ourselves feeling a strange sensation of disconnect from our surroundings, from other people, and from ourselves. Why does this happen? When did we become disconnected, or rather, alienated? Alienation is normally regarded as a constituent of the term social alienation, a term we use to describe a state in which an individual feels like he doesn't belong to a group or society in large due to a conflict of values, practices, beliefs, social and economic status, etc., etc. This state may sometimes be the source of our feelings of loneliness. We crave to be a part of a larger humane structure than ourselves. We want to be social members in our families, in our groups of friends, in our work environment, and feel like we belong with our fellow neighbors and citizens. When we differ from others, we are isolated, and the more we differ, the more isolated, alienated, and lonely we become. Therefore, some part of us strives to be like certain other people so we can assimilate into their certain groups. Yet it is not so simple, since before we become a part of society, we first come into this world as a person. Each of us with our own unique nature, our own special dispositions that have a major role in what person we will become as a result of their interaction with our environment. Unfortunately, our environment does not come prepared with a perfect mold to accommodate us. We learned that if we want to avoid social alienation, we must alienate something else first. We must alienate ourselves. We always end up having to give up on some parts of ourselves if we want to fit in. The problem of alienation comes back in a form of self-alienation when we attempt and fail to change, when we begin to forcefully fake who we are in order to belong to groups. That is when, even though we are a part of the group, we find ourselves feeling that feeling of disconnection and loneliness regardless. Whether you are expected to adopt a role based on your gender or your religion, whether the people around you value material prosperity and you value spiritual prosperity, whether your friends go to an engineering school and you want to be an actor, whether the city life you were born into is loud and abrasive, or rather the rural life of yours is dull and uninspiring, whether you enjoy this genre of music and everyone else around you despises it, you will always meet some kind of conflict against your environment. So, sacrifices have to be made. Of course, these things move on a spectrum. Sometimes you meet less conflict, sometimes the values of the group are naturally your values. Sometimes you don't have any rigidness to your identity and you happily harmonize with your surroundings. This is the lottery of life, and the way you win it is through balance between the self and the environment. We also have three ways to lose, two of which have been mentioned: social alienation and self-alienation. The third way to lose is to combine both: total alienation. Imagine a state of an all-rounded detachment, when you feel both socially alienated and self-alienated. Essentially, you belong nowhere, to no group, to no time nor place. It's a feeling of only existing as an idea. There's a lack of vitality in the world and a loss of connection with oneself. Relationships feel hollow, there is no understanding of who you are nor what you want to do, and even the material world loses all substance. Everything and everyone becomes small pieces of paper, stick together to form a world-sized picture of nothingness. The only way out is through connection. When we lose connection with people, we lose touch with reality. When we lose connection with ourselves, we lose another part. And when we lose both, we feel as if we are not embedded in the world anymore. We become detached and then lonely. There's a need for someone to reach out and grab our hand. There's a need to focus on the concrete world again and see, smell, hear, and feel anything. There's a need to be pulled out from insides of one's own catacomb-like house and into the here and now, back into existence. Sometimes it's with the help of a certain someone. Sometimes it's by inspiration, by hearing or seeing something that moves you within with great strength. Sometimes from the suffering alone, you reach a point so low and painful that you can't help but chase yourself out of this state and establish a connection with anything or whomever you can establish it. Something needs to take those same pieces of paper and turn them into volumes, rekindle the flames of passion and excitement of experience, so we can feel like we're again within reality and not looking in from the outside, so we stop feeling lonely.